Okay, go.
Okay. Mr. Leong, could you start by telling us how Kong Chow Clan Association was started?
Okay, the Kong Chow Clan Association was formed in 1840. So Singapore was founded in 1819 by Stamford Raffles. And that few years, the British, they actually opened up the Singapore Harbour. First, they started the Singapore River. So, and during that time, they need a lot of labourers, the coolies. So, the convenient place for them to get is from China, this Pearl River Delta region, that is Guangdong, because that is the easiest for them to get out of China. And during that time, in fact, 1820 something, a lot of the members from the Kong Chow region came to Singapore again. So when they came to Singapore, they start to form a community to take care of each other, especially in terms of welfare. And the association was formed mainly to provide an accommodation for the Kong Chow people before they get a job, for them to stay, and also probably sometimes provide food for them. And it's also a network community to know who so-and-so and who is who from their own hometown.
So how has the role of the association changed today?
So this role actually maintained all the way until after the 1920, after that the Second World War started, and after the Second World War China went into the communist country. So after that, then there are not many actually immigrants from China. So the association actually perform the role of taking care of the immigrants for I think for the most number of years, more than 100 over years. So after the Second World War, there are actually less Chinese immigrants who came to Singapore. So during that time, the association actually has about thousands to 2,000 over members. So in order to keep themselves alive, they also so-called bring along their hometown culture, arts and culture, and they actually use the association as a base. So that's how Lion Dance, the Cantonese Opera, the Dragon Dance, the Martial Arts started in the associations. And during that time, Singapore, we still don't have all these so-called cultural items. So in fact, the indigenous Singapore culture started from all these old Chinese land associations, where they brought the culture from China.